going to study about the written and unwritten rules and regulation. So there are some written documents and unwritten regulations. What are those here? Custom, tradition and value systems, these are unwritten. It is not written, just it is followed by ancestors. So we follow this custom, traditions and value system. And written in the sense here, where we are following our day-to-day, the rules and regulation which is done by judiciary. Okay, we follow that rules. Yes, it is maintained in a constitution law. For example, here 21A article, what it implies? Compulsory and free education. We have the fundamental rights here. Right against exploitation, right to education, right to freedom. So, and these are the rules and regulations where we follow. It is written. Okay. The next is called interconnected relationship. In a traditional society, the family take care of bringing up a child, whereas in modern society, the school share the role of bringing up a child. So your child staying in a family, he try to learn all the tradition and custom, how the family is, right? And it is given by the family for a child here. Whereas in now in modern society, where we can see, do we see this? In modern society, it's very rare to see. But when we move on to the Gurukula education, how was the education? How the family members were treated for the children? It is now where in modern society, we see that, but not so compared to the ancient. The school also shares a bringing up a child. Yes, even the school, a child coming for the school, it teaches the moral value for the child. Yeah, right? And the children, they are not only from one family, different family, from different family, the different children come to the school to gain education. Now let us study about the importance of social institution that is called the medium of culture. What is this medium of culture? This medium of culture transfer culture aspect like knowledge, custom, value and other generation to generation. So now, medium of culture. Like knowledge, custom, value and other generation to generation. Yeah, children, when we see to the present era, education is done compulsory for each and everyone. Either it's a girl or a boy. But when we compare to the olden days, ancient old, do the girls were valued more for education? No, they were not given a much importance for the education. And just it was given importance for boy for the education. They were not allowed to get education, they were not supposed to come out from the houses. But now we see equally given for education for both girl and a boy here. We see in a society, right? And next comes here customs and values. So here when we have the festivals like Deepavali, Ganesh Chaturthi, Ramzan. So here, do each and everyone celebrate in same way? Deepavali, it's a light festival. So they have their own customs and traditions here where they try to follow their own customs and traditions on the basis of their religion. They give importance. And when they're following this to that, it will carry to one generation to another generation. Next comes, fulfill the needs of the member. The needs of the human being also regulate the behavior. So here, if you behave well, by seeing us, even a small child also behave well. So he or she must be trained from a small. If they are brought up in very good, the child will grow up in a very decent manner, discipline. He tried to learn the rules and regulation. He tried to respect each and everyone. He learned the value and customs. Define and regulate the behavior of member. Define behavior of a bad and a good. So how do we define here? Comparing to the both. A person and B person, see the behavior of the person, how smart, how good looking, how well disciplined, how well cultured. And another person where he don't know how to behave, irresponsible of his own, he don't know how to respect. So we compare it, it's a person just give on speaking of nonsense things, a bad way, where he disrespect. So in a sense it create, that is a bad behavior. For example, in a school, you come well dressed in a neat uniform. Can you come in your, in a sense, your color dress as if you wear for the function and can you attend for the school? No, a school will have some principles that you follow that you will be in uniform. So you define it, yes, I learn certain things in a school that it motivates, it guides a good discipline, a punctuality, a good behavior, a good conduct that comes in school. The school corrects a bad behavior. Yes, if a child is behaving very bad, how to bring up in a good way? It maintains, in the sense, it try to correct the wrong things of a child. This is wrong. What the way you are speaking is wrong. You have to respect. You have to do this work. You should be in very good, well dressed. A punishments will begin. Imagine you are not done your homework. What your teacher will do? Do she say to enter the class? No. She says you to complete the work either by sitting down or by making you to stand and complete. Or if you are just talking in a class when the class is going on, she may say you to stand for 10 minutes or just write on an imposition that you are making a disturbance in a class to correct the mistakes, not to carry on once again. And the desired correction, yes. Once the correction has been done, the child will learn, I should not do. If I do once again, my teacher will punish it. If I do this, my mom will punish it. I should be in time. I should take permission for playing. So these all you learn from where? From the family, from the school. The next comes here, social institution provide role to individual. How it signifies here, the members, those are staying in a family, either they are the age-old people. So yes, they are the vital role they play in a family. They try to correct our mistakes. They say this is right, this is wrong. Family assigned relationships based on the age similarly. Social institution assigned role to member by defining the relationship here. So in a family, now we see to the modern family. In a modern family, we see just parents and siblings. But when we stay together in a joint family, we learn so many things. We learn the moral values. Next, let us move to the last, called religion. Your children in this topic, functions and role of institution and functions of marriage, it's dropped. So you have a topic that is called a religion. Religion is another social institution that is formed in a society called a socialization. Religion is one of the main medium of socialization that gives us a moral value, truthfulness, patience, peace and sacrifice. Next comes social unity. This is also one of the fosters unity, honesty and non-violence. Religious value that aid a social unity, and by employing symbols and custom, religion creates unity among the members. So what do this religion? So do we have a right to speak on religion? No, we don't have a right to speak on religion. So here, different religion follow their own customs and traditions here, so we don't have a right to speak on any religion. Protection of value, how do we protect our values here? Preservation of value, like truthfulness, yes, always we should speak the truth. Can you speak a false? We have done a mistake. A person has done some mistake here, can you say, no, I didn't do that? Blame can be done by an innocent person? No. So we should be always honesty and we should always speak truth and non-violence. Last comes here, social control. This is a major mean of achieving social control. It controls the human life through God and spiritual concept here. So imagine here, a 5 times ibadat. If you are not doing an ibadat, is it good? One time you'll do, second time you'll do, and next time you'll do only for once. So here it makes alertness by our parents that 5 times you have to do your ibadat. Religion guides its members to be disciplined and civilized. There is a need to understand dysfunction of religion and stop hating other religion. Yes. So here the guidance is given by our family members. They teach us what is the importance of our religion, what it is, how. And every religion teaches to love other religion. So we should not go against the religion. And there is a need to understand this function of religion and stop hating. Yes, the same thing I said you here. We should love the religion so we don't have a right to speak on any other religion. I hope you followed this topic, children. Thank you.